Hello everyone, I'm Ricky from Ricky's Tech Talk, and in this basics video on the Samsung Galaxy Z Flip 3, we're going to go through the setup process, showing you what's involved and what you need to change and make this device your own. So if you have a visual impairment or another ability that affects you in life, you may need to go and have a look in the accessibility settings. So one thing I like to know here with Samsung is that they have such a huge amount of settings and options inside here that you can change and adjust to help your ability. So that's a really nice option. And what we're going to do is actually continue. Now it's going to ask us to select our language, English, United Kingdom, that's correct, next. Then we have terms and conditions that we need to agree to use the best of this device, and I'm going to hit agree. The next step is to choose your Wi-Fi. So at home, I recommend you using your Wi-Fi internet connection if you have one. If not, you can skip or you can turn off Wi-Fi. I'm going to skip for the process of the video because I'm going to use the mobile data. What you would do is select your home Wi-Fi, enter your password, and then continue, but I'm going to skip. Now it's just going to check your phone for updates. Now it moves on and asks you about copying apps and data. So you can say don't copy, or you can go next. Once pressing next, you can use your old device, sync it up, and then move over data. If you don't want to do that option, you then have other options here to carry on. So we're not going to do that, and we're going to carry on with the setup process. The next step is to sign in with Google. So you'll need your Google account to get all of your apps, games, movies, TV shows, and also to use all of Google's services. So I'm going to sign in with my Google account now. Once you've signed in, it will say welcome. And if you hadn't had an account, you could also create one. So agree. Again, it's just going to get my content for me from other accounts. And also you could move over data if you want to. So no backup found, so that's okay. I don't want to use a backup anyway. I want to use my device fresh and new. It's now asking me to check the date and time is correct. That's correct. So we're going to hit next. Then we're going to choose which Google services we want to use. So I actually toggle off the backup because I use so many devices here at Ricky's Tech Talk. I would fill my backup easily so quickly. But otherwise, I keep all the other services on. Actually, moving through the phone, you can feel where the actual fold is or the flip side of the screen, but it's okay. It's an improvement over the previous generations. So choose your search provider. So you have to choose now here in the UK. I'm going to stick with Google though. So just toggle this box, hit next. Then we move on to protect your device. So you can protect your phone via face recognition, fingerprints, pattern, PIN, or password. So we're going to choose fingerprint. So fingerprint is fine. Then we're going to have to choose a backup option, and I'm just going to choose PIN. And you're going to ask to be entered a minimum of 4-digit PIN here, and you'll need to repeat this. So your fingerprint sensor is your power button. So once I place my thumb on there, you can see I'm starting to fill it in, and it will let you know if you've done this incorrectly. There we go, so I haven't done it correctly. And the percentages are just growing. And all I'm doing is moving my thumb around. Brilliant, so that is done now, and we can also add another fingerprint if we wanted to. So next, again, just check in for any updates. See what's trending with Google, and it's going to push information to me. That's fine. And then would I like to install any applications I've had on previous devices? Again, that's okay. So that's going to start to install those for me. And this is where you maybe need to sign in with your internet Wi-Fi connection, just because you don't want to use all of your mobile data. We've got recommended apps here from Vodafone, because a massive thank you to Vodafone who supplied the phone. So again, we'll agree to this. The next step is to sign in with your Samsung account. You can do this with Google, or you can sign in. I'm just going to skip for the process of the video. And it's going to tell you all the reasons why you don't want to skip, but I highly recommend you do sign in. So I'm just going to skip for the process of the video. And then finally, it's got a step here about taking care of your device. And I highly recommend you spend some time to look through this and read this, because this is a pioneering device, the folding display, it is different. So please take care and look at this page. So you're all set up and ready to go. So that was the setup process on the Samsung Galaxy Z Flip 3. However, if you do have any questions or queries, leave a comment below and I'll be more than happy to help. Also, make sure to subscribe to stay updated with all of my latest new launches of videos. And also give this video a like, as it really does help. For me, Ricky, thank you for watching and have a great day.